Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala program. I am Renu Arora, former head education and training division, NISCARE CSIR, New Delhi. I am here on behalf of Dr. Usha Pawan, former associate professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Rajasthan. We are going to cover today the module on geographical sources, use and evaluation. This is under the paper Information Sources, Systems and Services. There are many occasions during the course of reading, writing or in daily life to know more about a place or other geographical features which a person has come to know about. This module intends to acquaint the readers with geographical sources of information, their use and evaluation. This will help the users in performing the activity of acquisition of such sources in the library and in providing useful geographical information to the library patrons in the reference service activities of the library. Let's take a look at the objectives of this module. Firstly, to permit the users conceptualize geographical sources of information. Secondly, to list typical gazetteers, atlases and travel guides, etc., that help in providing geographical information. Thirdly, to help users evaluate different categories of sources of geographical information. And lastly, to describe a few typical gazetteers, atlases and travel guides, etc., used as sources of geographical information. In fact, for any library, it may be a school, college, university or a special library, it is important for the library to maintain a few geographical sources of information in its collection, because the users of all categories, of all levels, they require at some point or other the geographical information. So these sources help the users in many ways. Let's take a look at categories of geographical sources of information. We can broadly group the geographical sources of information into two categories. Firstly, the general reference sources. This category includes encyclopedias, yearbooks, almanacs, etc., which also contain geographical information. For example, maps of various countries and regions of the world, brief description of important places, and some geographical information about longitude, latitude, etc. But with these sources, a librarian is not in a position to answer the possible questions of geographical nature. Hence, the library has to acquire specific sources for this purpose which give detailed and specific geographical information. The second category is a solution to that, which is the specific geographical information sources. As these can be inferred from above, this category of sources are designed to offer specific as well as detailed geographical information. The users who wish to take up travels or learn more about other countries or other places or in order to indicate some particular place on a map should try to look at the specific geographical information sources. Broadly, there are three types of specific geographical sources of information. As displayed in the chart, these are gazetteers, maps and atlases, and travel guides. Let's take a look at what gazetteers are. A gazetteer may be defined as a geographical dictionary, differing from the index to an atlas in that it is usually more comprehensive. A good gazetteer includes names of towns, villages, rivers, mountains, lakes, and other geographical features, population, longitude, latitude, and in some cases, brief or even long entries tracing the history, economic, and political features of the particular place. Maps and atlases are a major source of geographical information. These are used by the specialists as well as the layman. A map is a representation of certain boundaries of the earth on a flat surface showing countries, bodies of water, cities, etc. On the other hand, an atlas is a collection of maps, tables, charts, etc. Whereas a globe is a spherical presentation of the Earth. According to ALA Glossary of Library and Information Science, a map is a representation normally drawn to a scale and on a flat medium of a selection of material or abstract features on or in relation to the surface of the Earth or another celestial body. The definition given by Rayleigh Ashley Skelton, former superintendent of the map room of British Museum, is: a map is a graphic document in which location, extent, and direction can be more precisely defined than by the written word, and its construction is a mathematical process strictly controlled by measurement and calculation. Travel guides inform and help travelers with details about different geographic places or tourist destinations. The guides provide a variety of information like addresses, phone numbers, hotels, restaurants, car rentals, places of visit, weather conditions, places of adventure or trekking, etc. Many guides have been available for all parts of the world. With the tourism industry flourishing and with a heavy competition, there are a variety of publishers in the field. With increase in use of electronic sources, especially on mobiles or other handheld devices with apps, and a number of dedicated sites on the net dealing with such information, often the printed travel guide publishers have electronic version of guides which could be downloaded in handheld devices for use. They have websites to present latest information. An example of folder guide can be taken here, which provides printed as well as electronic information from its website to offer latest information. There are several categories of geographical sources of information. Maps, atlases, and globes are some of the best examples of geographical information sources. Like gazetteers, maps and atlases are a major source of geographical information. These are used by the specialist as well as the layman. As a concept, a map is a representation of certain boundaries of the Earth on a flat surface showing countries, bodies of water, cities, etc. On the other hand, an atlas is a collection of maps, tables, charts, etc., whereas a globe is a spherical representation of the Earth. Usually, a collection of maps bound in a volume like a book is termed as an atlas. Atlas may be an independent publication or it may have been issued along with one or more volumes of text. A map and a globe are different in the physical shape. A globe is in fact a geographical image of the Earth in a spherical form. It is often a hollow spherical metallic ball with a world map on its surface. Very often, for easy viewing, it is mounted on an axis permitting rotation of the globe. The globe can be called a near natural representation of the Earth using a suitable scale. We may have seen globes in the libraries. With regard to atlases, these are very large publications, usually not placed along with other documents in the libraries. Because atlases are very huge in size and bulky, these are usually placed in separate places or separate corners of the libraries or on large tables for easy viewing by the users. Gazetteer. Gazetteers have been in existence since long. For example, the Imperial Gazetteer of India was and is a popular source of geographical and related information about British India. Gazetteers, whether old or current, are important. Older ones are a handy source of information for places which have changed with time. These also contain facts which are not included in revised editions or new gazetteers. The term gazetteer has been used in two senses. as the index to the Atlas and the other as an independent publication. In comparison to the index to Atlas, the Gazetteer as a separate volume, that is for a multi-volume publication, provides detailed geographical information, provides information on more and even far more smaller places. Physically, often it is easier to use by a user and it is easier to manage as a publication. For example, in shelving, binding, etc. Let's take a look at types of gazetteers. For the purpose of ease and use and study, the gazetteers are subgrouped into three categories. Depending on the geographical area of coverage, these are international or national or regional. Let's take a look at some international gazetteers. Merriam-Webster's Geographical Dictionary, 3rd edition, is one of the examples of international gazetteers. Chambers Word Gazetteer. National gazetteers include Imperial Gazetteer of India. This is in 26 volumes and was first published during the British period in 1881. District Gazetteer. After independence, the Government of India formulated a scheme in 1955 for revising district gazetteers. The states of India, while implementing the scheme, created gazetteer units or departments, which are responsible for compiling district gazetteer in each state. Now, as a result, most of the districts in India have a distinct district gazetteer giving detailed information. District gazetteers include comprehensive information with necessary background data, statistical data, and ancillary details on the historical, archaeological, political, administrative, economic, commercial, industrial, agricultural, sociological, cultural, and other aspects of district and life of the people with maps, charts, and tables. They also give list of such divisions as talukas, villages, etc. Some examples are district gazetteers in Bihar, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, etc. Evaluation of gazetteers. The gazetteers are evaluated before their acquisition in the library. For this purpose, the following criteria can be used: authority, scope, items of information, accuracy and currency, arrangement, special features. Let us examine each one of them in detail. Firstly, authority. Authority of the work can be judged on the basis of the reputation of the publishers, authors, and other contributors. Academic qualifications, specialization, and experience of authors, compilers, and other contributors are taken into consideration to judge this aspect. Scope. Scope refers to the limitations of the work as stated by the compiler with regard to the geographical area covered and other limitations. For example, Webster's Geographical Dictionary is an international gazetteer, but it excludes towns under 1500 population in the US and under 25,000 in Japan, China, etc. Items of information. It is important to know about the type and amount of information included for each geographical entity. The information about a geographical entry expected is name of place, pronunciation, location, area, population, geographical and physical description, economic and historical data, etc. Detailed information enhances its value. Accuracy and currency. This aspect of information about a place is extremely important. Random checks of some places known to users or the librarians should inevitably be made to verify this aspect. Arrangement. Usually the alphabetical arrangement is followed in most of the cases. However, the arrangement can also be alphabetic classed, where in broader areas can be arranged in a classed manner, and within each broader place entries can be alphabetically arranged. Some other variations are also possible. Lastly, special features. As a special feature, there may be a variety of information included in the gazetteers. For example, some of them may include maps, list of changed place names, etc. These form an added attraction and are helpful in finding such information for users in the library, which may be difficult to locate elsewhere. Finally, after evaluation, the librarian can take a decision whether a particular gazetteer should be acquired for the library reference collection or not. Typical examples of gazetteers, international gazetteers: Merriam-Webster's Geographical Dictionary, 3rd edition. Chambers Word Gazetteer. National Gazetteers, Gazetteer of India. District Gazetteers or of divisions such as talukas, villages, etc. Some examples can be seen as District Gazetteers in Bihar, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, etc. One of the first examples of geographical sources of information are gazetteers. Gazetteer, in the simplest terms, is a geographical dictionary. It differs from the index of an atlas in the sense that it is usually more comprehensive. A good gazetteer includes names of towns, villages, rivers, mountains, lakes, and other geographical features. Besides this, population, longitude, latitude, and in some cases, brief or even long entries which trace the history of a particular place are also covered. Also given are economic and political features of the particular place. Wikipedia defines a gazetteer as a geographical dictionary or directory which is used in conjunction with a map or atlas. They typically contain information containing the geographical makeup, social statistics, and physical features of a country, region, or continent. Content of a gazetteer can include a subject's location, dimensions of peaks and waterways, population, GDP, and literacy rate. This information is generally divided into topics with entries listed in alphabetical order. So, gazetteers are very important for public libraries and academic libraries, especially. Types of maps, atlases, and globes. As you can see in this slide, this can be divided into two categories: general and typographical, and special and thematical. In general and typographic category, we can see political, physical, topographical, economic or resource, road and route, etc. On the other hand, in special and thematic category, we can see human characteristics and physical phenomena. Let us explain this a little further. While general reference maps show where something is in the space, thematic maps tell a story about that place. For example, a city map. General and topographical division can have political, physical, topographical, economic or resource, road or route, etc. Often geological, geographical, political regularly appear together in maps. A thematic map is meant to focus on a specific theme. Special and thematic category can have geographical resources based on human characteristics, for example, on population density, physical phenomena, for example, on rainfall, etc. The thematic maps use the base data such as coastlines, political boundaries, and places only to portray context for mapping the theme. These divisions are only indicative and not exhaustive in nature. Again, each of the category or subgroup can be covering the whole world, that it may be international, national, regional, or may cover a smaller area. Evaluation of maps. Evaluation of maps requires special skills. Cartographic techniques like scale and size, projection, location key, etc. are also a point of consideration. The following can be considered for evaluation of maps. Firstly, authority. Authority with regard to reputation of the publisher, cartographers, and the editorial team members of the atlas is of importance. Like other reference books, reputation of the publisher is also very important. Authority can be established by reviewing the experience and qualifications of the cartographers and the editorial team members of the atlas. Scope and items of information. Scope refers to the limitations of the work as stated by the editorial team in the preface, foreword, etc. with regard to the geographical area covered, like international, national, etc., and other limitations. For example, the type of maps included, etc., or the information availability, that is longitude, latitude, area, population, astronomical data, roads, etc. Accuracy and currency. The accuracy and currency of information about a place is extremely important and makes or mars the value of the maps and the atlas. With time, countries or places are bound to undergo changes. Change in name of places or changes in topographical features, new dams, new roads, changes in city boundaries, etc. As a librarian or a user, one should make checks of some known changes to verify this aspect. One may also like to see the copyright of some of such maps where changes are most likely. To keep the collection in a current manner, the library should also plan to acquire, at least every few years, revised edition of atlases. The library should also retain individual maps from National Geographic magazine until new editions of atlases are acquired. Arrangement. For this aspect, one needs to look into the ways the maps are arranged. The arrangement may be on the basis of continents or countries within continent or according to the themes of the maps. The arrangement is depicted in the table of contents, but just a helpful arrangement of maps is not sufficient. An atlas must have a suitable index. An index to the maps or their location and the name of places on the maps, names of the features in the maps or the names of streets in the city and so on is essentially required in the atlas. Whereas the index refers to the grid or the exact longitude, latitude coordinates and the page number both. It has to be seen that index contains names of rivers, mountains, etc. in addition to place names. All such information, if available, enhances the value of the atlas. The index to all atlases should serve as a gazetteer. In index, availability of information about pronunciation, transliteration, and cross-references for varied spellings used is very helpful. Evaluation of maps. Let's take a look at some of the special features with regard to evaluation of maps. There are a variety of features to be observed in the maps and atlases while evaluating them. That is, scale, projections, colors, symbols used, grid systems, font types and size, marginal information on maps, binding of the atlas, etc. Librarian, while evaluating, should try to check such features which improve readability of maps, location of places in the maps, information available, adequacy of index, balanced coverage of different parts of the world, that is, lack of bias towards a particular geographical area, etc. An information-packed atlas may not be a quality work. As William Katz has said, many atlas publishers attempt too much and end up doing very little. An informative atlas may be a good buy for an individual, but a library should concentrate on quality of maps and indexes. The reason behind this is that library users have access to encyclopedias, almanacs, and directories, and thus an atlas need not be used to replace the utility of other reference sources. Scale. Scale is indicated on the base or a corner of the map. The larger the scale, the more readable the map is. However, some atlases do not use the same scale for all the maps. Projections. The earth is nearly spherical and to present it on a plane surface needs some projection techniques. A variety of projections have been developed to effectively present the earth's surface. Atlases and map specify the projections used. Location key or grid system. Location of a place or a feature in the map is done with the help of latitude and longitude. In terms of degrees, minutes, and seconds, many of the maps are subdivided into squares, rectangles called grids. With the help of grid square number, the index points out the location of a place feature in the particular map. Binding. As an atlas is often quite heavy publication and usually stays for a long time in the collection, it must have a good binding. The two facing pages of an atlas must open fully to afford proper view of the map. Usually, good atlases do have good binding. The atlas with more maps, a good and large index, a good printer publisher, and a reputed cartographer is a good atlas. It may be added that a single atlas may not be enough in a library. Often, a few good atlases with origin from different areas besides one's own country, say USA, UK, and Europe, may be required to create a balanced collection. A library, depending upon requirements of the users, may also think of acquiring single large maps for different geographical areas. Maps, atlases, and globes. Some examples. Some typical popular examples of different categories of maps and atlases have been provided in the subsequent two slides. International maps and atlases. First example is the Times Comprehensive Atlas of the World, edition 13 UK, 544 pages, 320 color plates. Second example is the New International Atlas, published from Chicago by Rand McNally. Third example is Hammered Atlas of the World. This is an electronic resource published by Hammered Inkling. Examples of national maps and atlases. National Atlas of India. National Atlas and Thematic Mapping Organization is the publisher, edited by Privish Nag. It was published in 1995. It is in 10 volumes. Secondly, Postcode Atlas of British and Northern Ireland, published by Collins in UK. Third example is National Atlas of China, published in 1964. It is in 5 volumes. Examples of local maps and atlases. The Atlas of Uttaranchal by Privitish Nag and Gopinath Saha, brought out by National Atlas and Thematic Mapping Organization of India. Aishwar City Map of Delhi City, including Faridabad, Ghaziabad, Gurgaon, Noida, etc. India South, including Andaman Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep, Special Map, Goa, City Maps, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Trivandrum, Physical Relief Mapping, Places of Interest, etc. are provided. Example of Special or Thematic Maps. Muir's Historical Atlas, Ancient, Medieval and Modern, edited by Treheme and Fullard. It's in the 10th edition presently. Second example is Atlas of Global Development, a visual guide to the world's greatest challenges. It's in the 4th edition, brought out by World Bank in paperback form in 2013. Another example is Administrative Atlas, brought out in 2011 by Registrar General and Census Commissioner, Government of India. It can be downloaded from the website of Census of India. Next in the category of geographical sources are travel guides. Travel guides help travelers with details about different geographical places or tourist destinations, as these provide a variety of information useful to travelers. For example, addresses, phone numbers, hotels, restaurants, rentals, places of visit, weather conditions, etc. Many guides are available for all parts of the world. With the tourism industry flourishing, there are a variety of publishers offering travel guides. With increase in use of electronic sources and a number of dedicated sites on the net dealing with such information, often the printed travel guides have electronic version, which could be downloaded in handheld devices for use. They have websites to present latest information. We have often seen tourists holding a small booklet in their hand. This is actually a travel guide of the particular place they are visiting. This gives information about all the available tourism places, places where one can shop, one can go to eat, one can stay, one can visit, etc. Also given is a route map. If there are buses or trains in the area, details of that are also provided in the travel guides. In fact, for all the countries of the world, all the major cities of the world, we have presently travel guides available. And travel guides are very often updated so that the latest information about a particular place is provided to the travelers. Travel guides evaluation. As tourism is becoming a big industry, it is natural that travel guides continue to proliferate at a fast speed. Travel information sources of a wide variety and quality are being produced, and the publishers' efforts are to cover both native and domestic as well as international travelers. This often makes it a bit difficult for the librarian to decide the source of information to be acquired from amongst the multiple choices of travel guides from a variety of sources. Further, getting guides for many regions and a balanced collection development is always an issue. Many publishers are highly reputed in this field and are thus the natural choice. A few such examples are also given in the course material. Important features to be considered are the variety of information included and its systematic arrangement, including maps, illustrations, the currency of information and its index. The currency and accuracy of information is essential so that the travelers are not misled. Types of travel guides. Travel guides are often categorized as one-time guides and guides in series. The one-time guides are published to introduce an area rich in history, ecology, or even of monuments, whereas the guides in series help tourists in planning their travel program. The latter category requires continuous revision and hence is published in series. In guides in series, naturally, the currency of information is extremely important. It is from this pressing need that with the availability of ICT, the publishers have developed travel guides in electronic format, which can be downloaded as an e-book and used with the help of a variety of palm tops, smartphones using apps and other handheld devices. With continued demand and development, there are now dedicated websites to cater to the tourists on the move, as the websites can afford to keep the information current and can be accessed quickly while on the move. Travel guides examples. Given below are some examples of travel guides. The first example is Tipso. It's available from https://play.google.com. Second example is Folders Essential India. This is a paperback publication by Trade Paperback Publishers, published in May 2013. Third example is Folders Essential India ebook. It is in 552 pages, published in May 2013. It is available at http://www.foders.com/guidebooks. Fourth example is Forbes Travel Guide. It is a series of travel guides for hotels, restaurants, and spas. In 2011, Forbes published its last set of guidebooks and on November 15, 2011, launched its new online home, ForbesTravelGuides.com, which covers more than 250 international destinations including Hong Kong, Singapore, Shanghai, London, etc. Last example is In Your Pocketbook. It is a European city guide publisher and online tourist information provider. As of April 2008, it published city guides to 68 destinations and provides free online information to over 100 cities in 23 countries in Europe. Lastly, to sum up, in this module, we have discussed need for various types of geographical sources of information, ways of evaluating the geographical sources of information, the usefulness of different types of geographical sources of information for library users. We have also learned about some typical geographical sources of information available in libraries. And lastly, we have seen how to make use of these sources to search specific geographical information. The other details, etc., about the geographical sources along with the examples and the publication details are provided in your course material. Also given is a bibliography and a bibliography for your reference.